Comment traduire il y a en anglais? Il y a deux façons de traduire il y a, soit there is, soit there are. Alors, there is, il y a peut se traduire par there is plus du singulier. Exemple, there is a cat in the garden. Il y a un chat dans le jardin. A cat qui est singulier, donc c'est pour ça qu'on va utiliser there is. Et la deuxième façon de traduire il y a, c'est there are, qui sera forcément suivi du pluriel. Exemple, there are 10 cats in the garden. 10 cats qui est du pluriel. Il y a 10 chats dans le jardin. Donc, au présent, on a vu un there is a cat. Il y a un chat. Au passé, donc prétérit en anglais, ça donne there was a cat. Il y avait un chat. Pareil pour le pluriel. Hein. There are two cats. Il y a deux chats. Au passé, c'est-à-dire prétérit en anglais, ça donne there were two cats. Thank you.
There was, there were. It means the same as there is and there are, but in the past, and we use them in the same way we use there is, there are, but to refer to it in the past. We use there was when there was only one thing. For example, there was one person on the street yesterday. We use there were when there were more than one thing. For example, there were two cars on the road last night. There were 10 tables in the classroom last month. When we want to say something that is uncountable, like water, gasoline, sand, pollution, money, salt, sugar, we use there was. For example, there was water on the table. There was money in my wallet. Now let's see how we make the negatives. As there was or there were has a verb to be, we just make the verb to be in negative. Look at the examples. There wasn't a cat in my house. There weren't windows in my bedroom. Now let's see the questions. As we have the verb to be, we just put the verb to be at the beginning of the sentence. Was there a ball in the garden yesterday? Were there good restaurants in your town last year? Remember that we can use the quantitatives like some, any, much, many, a lot of, with this verb.